elves have been in our culture for a very long, and to say about someone he's a kind of an elf is not smart. So when she said you are the best talking about elves, she was saying to me you are kind of an elf. But we are getting away from elves. Our culture is getting away from elves. So many young people, they don't know about it, and I think very few believe in it. But you may be thinking of the big stone out there, which is an old elf stone, belonged to my grandmother. She was, I don't know if you have seen the farm where the president resides, out of Reykjavik, across the bay, out of Reykjavik. In that area, my grandparents had a little farm. And it's on a peninsula, low land, that is sinking a little bit into the sea. So they are building stone walls around the beaches. And the farmers were cultivating the land, picking stones out of the fields, putting them into the protecting walls. And the guy who was in charge, he really wanted that stone. It was quite a good stone for protecting from the sea. Yeah. You know it from Holland, yes. But my grandmother protected the stone because she knew that elves lived in it. And then, and yes, I played with the stone as a child, as long as I remembered. Then my grandmother passed away, and we were 17 in my generation that inherited the farm. And as this area was becoming more and more residential area, they were building houses, putting asphalt on streets and all that, I came up with the idea that we would give the community a little piece of land and the stone in the memory of our grandparents. And I was starting to talk about it to my co-owners when a man came to me with a paper to ask me to sign and allow them to build a road over the stone. I never signed that. They built the road, tipped over the stone, built the road, opened the road. 3 weeks, and a 17-year-old died in a car accident right by the stone. I know what my grandmother would have thought about that. And so many people in the environment, they connected it with elves. Then time passed by and we were forced to sell the farm for buildings. So then the stone was laying beside the road, would be cracked. So I got a big crane and a trailer, and it was the third crane that could lift. The first two failed, they were too little. So the crane had 10 big wheels, and he could lift it and moved it here. Before I thought to the elves, and I thought that way, I said, if they are against it, they would let me know. They know what I'm thinking. I had been thinking about it for 2 years, and I got no warning, so I did. Has brought luck, yes. So we are glad about that. And, well, I cannot say that I believe in elves, haven't seen them. And this is my only communication with them, to give them the possibility to warn me. But it's a fact that I acted. Yeah. I did this. So yeah. I'm influenced by elves somehow. And this grandmother of mine that I mentioned, that had the stone, as a child, she saw a ghost, which is quite another thing. And she, well, she didn't think that she saw a ghost. She was convinced. And as an, as an elderly lady, she was not taller than this. She played it when she saw the ghost. Then I was standing like this. Then he came like this. He played both roles. It was very funny. My grandma, my child thought it was very funny. But she believed in this.
And what did she see? What happened?
Well, I don't know what. Just to see the ghost was the big thing. Nothing happened.
No.
This was a very famous ghost from this area, symbol from this area here. Most Icelanders would know the name of that ghost.
Okay. So how does it look like?
I don't know. I cannot explain it. Okay. No, I'm not very much into that. This is a little bit out of my interests. As you can see, I have a very square head. and square thinking. So, you can find people that are more into this.
Yeah, yes. But are you talking about this with this Hultefolk?
Yes, that's elves.
Elves.
Yes,
okay.
That's the same. They are good. They are small. They are clean and good. But the ghosts, they are the opposite. They are
but
bad.
They are not all small in the stories. No, the Hultefolk.
Yes, they are.
They are like, look like us.
Some of them.
Yes, we have heard.
Yes.
And they come out of the stones open sometimes.
We try
to get people into the stones to them.
Yes.
And then the stone closes.
And the people disappear.
Yeah.
They come out again.
Yes, not all. Some disappear into the stones, don't they?
Who?
Yeah,
in the stories. and sometimes they come out and ask for help. If like someone cannot have a baby and needs a help.
Yes.
That's the stories say.
Yeah.
Yes. And then ladies that are good helping ladies in giving birth to a baby, they go in and help. And then they usually brings luck.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
I heard that they take men.
Oh,
some
yes.
Elves?
Oh, yes.
Elf ladies?
They take men.
Yeah, in the mountains you go.
Yes.
You cannot go alone because the elf ladies will take you.
Mm-hmm. Yes. That's or you prefer to go alone.
And we have
very old songs about elves. And we have them in common with Faroe Island people and Norwegian Olav Liljeros. Can you do that for
Liljeros,
Liljeros. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, also in Faroe Islands. Mm-hmm. They are celebrating the death of Olav den Helge.
Mm-hmm.
This is connected. This is connected. Mm-hmm. And their national festival, Olavsvaka, is in memory of that, and then they sing the elf song that we sing here too.
Mm-hmm. Going back to the elf stone, when he was doing this, and this he was following the crane, and I was going into town, and I met them on the road, this big crane with this big stone, and I thought, well, if they don't want to move up to us, then the stone will roll on my car, and they will tell me by that. But nothing happened, and I thought, well, they are not against them.
Alvur.
Hultefolk.
That's sheep, right? It's female.
Alvur is han. It's
female. It's a masculine name, but it is for both sexes, of course. It's a generic term.
Okay.
But then we say Hultemadur, which is a male, and Hultekona, which is a female.
Okay.
Hultefolk is
in my thought. Hultefolk is much better people than Alvur.
Well, in my mind it's the same. Yeah. So.
And trolls?
No.
Trolls
they are ugly.
That's something that you scare something you scare children with. It's your ugly big noses.
Trolls are something that used to be, they don't exist anymore. And they, you know about the trolls, they can't stand the sunshine or daylight.
Okay.
So they travel by night, and if they are too late and get a little sunshine, they become stones. So we have trolls here and there, but no living troll. Do we have? No. No, we don't know of any. No. They are big.
And Troll is something that is scary.
Yes.
Yeah. Definitely.
I would guess this would be more in Norway.
Yeah, and we call them Zwarte Piet.
It's
Black Piet, we call them. These are the helpers of Santa Claus, and they bring presents. So for the children, and they put their shoes by the stove, by the fireplace.
Yeah.
And they sing songs and put like a carrot in the shoe for the horse, for Santa Claus. And they get a present from Santa Claus.
And Santa Claus looks different. He
looks different. Yeah, he has he looks like the Pope.
Santa Nicholas.
Santa Nicholas.
There was a little elf boy that dropped this pot. It was the last one out of a long line of elves that were coming, going home into the rocks.
Okay.
And this elf boy was the last of his people coming there, and he was kind of struggling with holding on to the pot, and the rest of the elves were nearly all the way into the rock, when he kind of had to drop the pot just to catch up with them, and he caught up with the rest of the elves and they disappeared, and that pot got left behind. And so a few witnesses were to this event, people that were going from another farm to the next, and they witnessed this trail of elves coming home, and they picked up the pot. At least that's how I think the story goes. It's called the Vikivaka, at least in the Faroe Islands, and it tells the tale of Olaf Liljeros when he meets some of the elves. There's a different Icelandic version and a different Faroe version to that.
So you have two or more legends about legends?
Yes, at least that's kind of the version. Then it goes back to it ends the same way and such. Mm-hmm. But it's kind of similar.
Okay, so an elf?
Bad to encounter them in most cases, but they can, if you're good to them, they can grant you boons, according to all those legends. But generally, it's bad to meet them. There's another story, another song called. What was it? Á Sprengisandi. Basically, Sprengisandur is in the middle of the highland. Of basically, nobody lives there. So too far from the ocean. It's a big desert, really. And there's a poem or a song that is about someone. It doesn't name anyone. That is going over that way. In the third verse, he talks about he would give his best horse not to meet the elf queen. Something like that. Culture or something. In Ireland, almost entirely, since all the stories are kind of just mirroring the general populace. So, although we do have gentry, we do have a bit more noble people, most of the priests, for example, were also farmers. Thus, the fae here, the fair folk here, were more down to earth, I think, than in Ireland and other places that speak of elves. Mm-hmm. God, I'm going to be pulled into hell with this. Yeah, anyway.
Okay. That's very interesting. Thank you so much. So now we go into the
faux glow.
Yeah. For piece of clothes.
Yeah.
Which should be embroidered another way to compare with other artifacts, right?
Yeah, I think so. It looks different. According to Claudia, I don't know exactly what piece of cloth he is talking about, but right. I do believe so.
So my friend lives in a house where a stone is just in the middle of her cellar.
Okay, so and it's not removable, it's just standing as it is?
Yeah, it's pretty removable and it's almost destroyable, but we don't want to do anything with it because of the stories around it.
And how old is your friend?
Oh, she's my age.
Okay.
She's the one who lives with her parents, so I don't think it may be her parents that is. But I think if I would move into the house, I wouldn't do anything with it either.
We're really thankful for this artifact and your little story.
Yes.
So I hope our friends will be so happy to know more about.
There are many stories of elves, and that in my town, when I grew up, when I was a kid, the council of the town was going to build a new road, and so they were having all these machines that were making a flat road. But then they came to a big rock, and the machines broke down. They could not move the rock. Whenever they came close to it, the machines broke down, they couldn't use it, and there was just this machine and the other machine, you know, all of them. So what they did is that they made the road, it was completely straight, except that then it bends around this rock and then it keeps going straight again. And the name of the road is Álfhólsvegur, which is the road of the Elf Hill.
Okay.
About, and many stories about people that went into the rock and saw how beautifully the elves live. Uh-huh. Everything is golden and bright inside
the rocks.
Oh yes, and they are all very tall and gracious, and they dress very nicely, and they have lots of gold.
Oh, and how they became so rich?
I don't know. Maybe they have a special a pact with the dwarves, because the dwarves are the ones who dig out the gold.
Okay. You wanted to meet.
Oh yes. Especially okay. The dwarves. Not so much the elves. I was a little afraid of them.
Okay.
And I think that's quite common for people to associate with.
Mm-hmm.
Some kind of either spirits or just beautiful thoughts that have been thought in the house that you can feel the nice atmosphere. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But you mustn't be bad to them. You mustn't disturb their peace.
So you have to be friendly, nice,
yes.
Gentle.
And not ruin their house, of course. So you shouldn't move the rocks or be climbing on some of the rocks. So mm-hmm. You shouldn't be disturbing them. There's only very special people and very special occasions that can see the elves.
Thank you so much for your wonderful story.
You're welcome.